Hello everybody and welcome to Young Productions. My name is Tyler Young and today I'm going to show you how to put Raspbian Jessie onto your Raspberry Pi. So obviously the couple things that you'll need a micro SD card for the Raspberry Pi 3 and up, as well as a Raspberry Pi, of course. Make sure you have all the adequate power supplies and good things like that. So to get started, I'm going to show you how to do this tutorial based off a Mac machine. Hopefully a Windows version will be coming soon, and I can show you how to do that whenever I get on my Windows computer set up. So first we're going to go to Safari. We're going to go to raspberrypi.org. Now we're going to go to the Downloads tab, and we're going to click on Raspbian. And then we're going to want to download Raspbian Jessie with Pixel. Now, when you're watching this tutorial, it may be called Raspbian something else, you know, for an updated version. So we're going to download the zip file. You can download the torrent file, but it takes a little bit longer, and we don't really want to fool with that. So while you get that downloading, I already have it downloaded, so I'm not going to do it again. We're going to want to go to PiFiller. So we'll search that on Google. And it's by Ivanex, so ivanex.com, and we want to download the latest version of PiFiller. So once that's all downloaded, I already have it all ready to go, we're going to go into our Spotlight search, and we're going to go to our Disk Utility. Now here's an important step, depending on what you want to use everything for. So we want to format our disk using XFAT. Now, if it's a SDXC card, which means that it exceeds 32 gigabytes, you want to use the XFAT option. If it's below that, you can just use the MS-DOS FAT32. So I have a 64 gig card, so we're going to do XFAT. And of course, be sure that you're clicking on the right volume. You don't want to delete your internal hard drive on your computer. That would be very bad. You can name it whatever you want to. I'm going to name mine Raspberry Pi. And let's click Erase. And this just ensures a good format and that everything is going good. This may take a minute just depending on what you're doing, how big your card is, and what you have stored on it. So once it's done, you'll just click Done, and we're going to get rid of Disk Utility here. Let's click that off. Now we're going to go to our... Actually, first things first, we're going to eject our Raspberry Pi disk, the SD card. We're going to unplug it. Get that out of the way just for a second. Now we're going to... where you downloaded the Jessie OS, you're going to get a zip file. Once you extract that, there'll be two files inside. There's going to be a Raspbian Jessie zip and a Raspbian Jessie IMG. That's an image file. We want to use that image file for what we're doing here. So let's go to our PiFiller application that we downloaded from Ivanex. It's going to say, hey, if your SD card's in your machine, please take it out. So we've already done that, so we'll hit continue. Now it's going to prompt us to search for our IMG file. So we're going to click the latest version of the IMG file that you just downloaded, and we're going to click choose. Okay, now it's prompting us to insert the SD card. So we'll plug that in now. There it is there, so we're going to click continue. It's going to take just a minute to look for your SD card, and then it says, hey, I've got it here, it needs to be formatted and erased. I went ahead and formatted it before, it's going to go ahead and do it again. It doesn't hurt to format it before because it's just kind of an extra security measure. It's going to do it anyway, but we just want to make sure. So we're going to go ahead and click continue. It says, hey, you know what? This can take 30 minutes or more to do. So we'll click erase SD card. We put in our administrator password for our machine. And it's going to say, okay, we're getting started here. It's going to give you an estimated time remaining. This is putting the image file on your disk, and it's also erasing it at the same time. This shouldn't be too lengthy of a process. If you're running an older Mac OS machine, it may take a minute. So we'll let that process complete. Okay, so everything has been put on there, and it'll give you a message here. It says your SD card is ready. Go put it into your Raspberry Pi. So we'll just click quit. And we can actually just pull the SD card out because it's already ejected and the Mac doesn't actually recognize it as a card anymore. So now we're going to place the SD card into the Raspberry Pi and plug it in. You should get a boot screen like this, and then you just follow the on-screen instructions to get you going. As always, guys, if you like our videos, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel. Please comment if you have any questions. This is kind of a lengthy process. Thanks again, and we'll see you in the next one. God bless.